How are you doing this afternoon? My name is Matthew Wright. I go by Matt. I live in Richmond, Virginia. I'm a spiritual teacher and leader in Richmond and the Metro Virginia area. And I'm a psychic medium, spirit medium, and a empathic intuitive.
My name is Jeremy Elliott. I'm also from Richmond, Virginia. I'm a spiritual teacher and leader. I'm also a psychic, a clairvoyant, and a medium.
And we wanted to do this, to help you out. We help spirits on their side that come to us, and also physically embodied spirits, or basically human beings. Another way to put it, human, that come to us asking to contact the spirit world. But this is the case of the former. I was watching news report about Sean here. And it came on this morning. I've seen him before, but this time, it came on, and he was like, pop, pop, there he is. And as soon as I woke up this morning, he himself is there in the room asking for help. So we're going to help him. We help anybody, no matter where they live, who they were, who they weren't, how they lived their lives, don't matter to us. We're here to help. That's all we do. We don't charge anybody anything. We never have, never will. We just do this out of love. Love for people here, love for the other side, and we care about Sean too. And we didn't know him in life, but yet we still care. We're trying to help. But I'm going to let Jeremy start out with this,
Well, he's coming through very strongly, maybe very dark, not very dark skin, but dark skin, short hair. He does wear a hat sometimes, I see it's like a gray sweatshirt, long sleeve. He's here,
Oh yeah, oh yeah. We were talking to him, not Jeremy, but about an hour ago. He was coming through. Another friend that works with us, a friend of mine named Christy. She can, she can hear their telepathy real good and feel spirits and emotions especially well. But Sean was she felt it, this crying and stuff, flat out weeping, very, very sad.
He's got that on his mind, he thinks that what happened to him was brutal, but he forgives him, But he has all this worked up sadness, emotion about it, because he can't come from the other side and say to the people in his family, forgive them, because they don't know what they did, the same thing that Christ might have said or something.
That's true.
He can't do it, but he wants to. That's where he's caught up in this emotional,
emotional backdraft or emotional baggage from the event itself. What happens is when spirits drop physical bodies, they can read people's mind, thoughts, all emotion instantly. And then anytime someone thinks about them or cries over them or feels grief or happiness or love, they know about it and they're drawn to them.
Yeah.
So what's going on with Sean here is that's what's going on.
Yeah.
Y'all are in the terrible grief and rage and anger and denial.
It's shifted him all around, as far as his emotions, He's forgiven him, the thing is, he does think it was bad of him. And maybe it was bad, But he also understands it on a different level, where it's a cycle of life, too. Now he does, He states to his family, that, please, try to forgive, don't stir up things, there's no reason to. But, see, they're going to stir things up. That's why he's saying it.
Yeah, they've been stirring things up.
Yeah.
I've seen it on the news itself.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that, Sean, just so much of that. And you're right, I thought that, look, sometimes you have to forgive. Even if you're very upset, very hurt, sometimes you have to forgive. Sometimes there's no other way but to let go and forgive.
Yeah, because there's no way to take down, what they're trying to do. You know what I mean?
That's right.
So, it's, with the whole New York Police Department and all this. Yeah. This is what I'm saying. There's no way to tear that down.
That's right.
So why go that way? Just forget it and move on.
It's not going to bring Sean back.
Right.
And I hate to say that. I know that's hard to hear, but
he's okay. That's what he's saying. You know, he's happy here. You know, that's what he's saying. I'm happy here. He has a lot of energy.
But the emotion from this dimension here where we are is, see how much it's hurting him, dragging him down.
Yeah, it's very negative, you know. It's not that.
Not that y'all did anything wrong.
Right, exactly.
But the thing is, though, he just needs y'all to know he's all right. You know, he's especially missing his wife, right? Basically, y'all said you're about to get married, right? Yeah, like you said earlier.
Yeah.
Like, because Christie, when she was, when she and I were talking earlier, like, she said she felt this massive love connection between him and this woman, you know, spiritual soul connection almost, mm-hmm. you know, it's like,
yeah,
you know,
he loved her, man. He's telling me now, you know, I love her, because he's got this deep compassion, like, that's his woman only, woman, you know,
yeah.
No screwing around, nothing, you know, that's his woman, you know.
I got you.
No, you know, if what makes her happy made him happy, you see what I'm saying?
So, I mean, remember earlier that you said she's kind of having a hard time, right, son? Almost in denial, correct?
Yeah, angry, and she's turned her feelings into anger, you know, her emotions and things. She's, instead of crying, it's anger, you know. Not that she doesn't cry, says.
Yeah. But it's just anger, and that's even worse. The anger is going to be hard on. Anger tears you down, too. Like, you got to know that anger is hard on your own body and your soul. And he's feeling it.
That's coming a direct in. Connection with him, you know.
It's going right into him. Every time you get angry, it's right in him.
Yeah. He's a very, very sensitive man, you know. Not that he wasn't his own man's man, you know. He was kind of like, you know, but he's a sensitive, you know. I can see him, you know, he was a sir, you know, that's what he says, a sir.
A sir, I think I see what he's talking about.
A good man.
A good man, yeah. You know, like you said, what, man's man?
Maybe that word sir means something, you know what I'm saying?
Oh.
Okay, you know, with the family or something.
Oh, okay, yeah. I gotcha. But, what was it you were touching on earlier? Like, I know you said a bunch of stuff about that. I know you mentioned being drunk and stuff that night, but what was it you said about that, that you still just don't know why it would have happened like that? What was it you said earlier, Sean? I know you said something to that effect there when we were talking with Christy.
Yeah, he was just doing what he did, you know, chilling with his friends and everything, you know, and things just got a little wild, you know. And then things, one thing led to another, and then he was taken, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, there's really no good excuse for what happened. I can see it kind of, I can see both perspectives here, but what is done is what is done.
He was drunk. Yeah, he was drunk. Very drunk.
But you didn't have no gun or anything like that,
no,
did he?
No. No beef. No beef.
Anything.
No.
Yeah. Like, they were just too quick on the trigger.
Yeah, like, yep.
Too quick on the trigger, that's what I'm feeling, Sean.
Yeah.
You know, like, they just jumped on it, like, just didn't hesitate to pull the trigger.
A lot to do, because he said, you know, because of the you know, they were scared of them, you know, because it was a massive amount, a bunch of people. You know, if you imagine walking into a room full of, you know, mostly black guys and everything, partying, they're drunk, they're crazy acting.
Yeah.
You know, you got a couple of scared cops, you know, and they all just, things go, you know, forgives them, you know.
Oh, yeah. I mean, so it's basically, it's come down to the family left behind. Y'all need to, I mean, I know it's hard to hear, you know, but forgive. That's his message.
That is his message.
Forgive. You know, forgive for his sake and your sake. It's tearing him down, and it's tearing y'all down emotionally inside.
Tell the woman, you know, in his life to cry instead of
hate.
Yeah, not to hate, to cry. You know, fall apart instead of trying to
attack.
Attack.
She's not like, she's turned grief into attack.
Yeah.
And like sadness and the hatred.
It's okay to fall apart.